bodies getting shite done never hurt anything.
around here and you'll start glowing in the dark.
Than we have feet.
it to you, ain't it?
Yeah.
I've ruined my back. Wait. Know how to sneak properly. Thought they'd never leave.
More bodies getting shite done never hurt anything. Didn't your mum teach you better?
Oh, hello, stranger. How wonderful to meet you. Lovely day, isn't it?
I'm sorry, mate. I think you have me mistaken for somebody else. Nobody by that name here. I've never heard of such a person. You must be mistaken. Now, please stop talking to me before someone overhears us and gets the wrong idea. Huh?
Hey! We got intruders over here! Sound the alarm!
You unbelievable brainless git. You've really done it now. Fuck! Cause a distraction while I fix this massive clusterfuck you've put us in.
You've got a slap on the face, you know.
Nah, sorry. I've still got 2 hours left on the shift.
Oh, hello, stranger. How wonderful to meet you. Touch me again and there'll be consequences. I'm sorry, mate.
Oh, hello, stranger. How wonderful to meet you. Lovely day, isn't it?
One zombie is too many.
I'm sorry, mate. I think... Sounds good. Bye. Well, aren't you the chattiest chuffer in the churchyard? What on earth could you want now? I'm sorry, mate. I think you... I've never heard of such a person. You must be mistaken. Sounds good. Bye. Chattiest chuffer in the churchyard. What on earth could you want now? I'm sorry, mate. I've never heard of such... Huh?
Hey! We got intruders over here! Sound the alarm!
You unbelievable...
Some people just...
Bruh! come back to you. Lock the door behind you.
Well, look who it is.
I honestly don't know whether to hug you or strangle you right now. But since we're all alive and we left a trail of Syndicate members in our wake, I guess I owe you my gratitude. I've got to be honest, I was not thrilled to see you when you first showed up. But I'll be damned if you didn't save the day. Thank you. Oh, sweet, simple lab rat. One of these days you'll run out of luck. But until then, happy you're on our side.
Come in. Are you alive? Over.
Good to hear your voice, Gaunt. Despite the blundering of our trusty lab rat, everyone is alive and accounted for. Over.
Wait a minute.
alive because of the lab rat? Seriously? Gotta be chuffed to hear that. I didn't think they'd have it in them. And there we are now. Over. Gaunt said don't run off like that again. We can't afford to lose you. Wait, did you say despite the lab rat? What did they do? Over.
Well, let's just say what they lack in tact, they make up for in natural talent for killing Ayots. Honestly, if it wasn't for the lab rat, none of us would be alive right now. Over.
Impressive. Oi, lab rat. Nice work out there today. I think I speak for everyone on this end of the microphone when I say you finally proved yourself loyal to our little family. I better come back to see what Gaunt has to say, though. Better get your bums back to the Swan when the heat dies down. Over and out. Over. Over.
It's almost peaceful without all that noise.
Well, our little wayfarer has returned. You're looking in a lot better nick than when we first found you, I must say. I've been paying mind to what you've been up to round here. Seems you're not a bad sort, me old mucker. So listen, I got an opportunity for you. You can keep on doing odd jobs for us, help out here and there for a few tickets, or you can step up to the big game. I'm offering you the chance to join the ranks of the Vagabonds. Join our family proper. Your blood becomes our blood. Our fate becomes your fate. What do you say? Weapons, armor, support, a bit of status in the streets, and protection if you're ever in a corner. Us Vagabonds look after our own. Now, we ain't the only gang about. But unlike the rest, we ain't leeches. We ain't lording it over others. And we ain't fucking lunatics. You want to be someone's pawn? Go somewhere else. You want to be part of a real community? This is the place to be. Truth be told, I'm not sure of you myself. But Blind Nelson says he smells something special about you. And I'd be fucking balmy to ignore his nouse. I've got me some big plans coming up. And if you've got the right skills, you could play a big part in them. In a word, revenge. We've been at war with the fucking Isle of Dogs Syndicate for 10 years. And for too much of that, we've been on the back foot. We need to switch things up. Take the war to them and win it. Win it for good. Getting heavy, aren't we? Well, all I have to say is that's a bloody cup I want to savour every drop from. I'll suck the maggots from the filthy dog's flesh if I have to. Me old man used to talk about consolidating the boroughs, working together to stand up to the gentry, building a free London. He was a dreamer, my father. But that dream died when the syndicate took his life away. More to hope for than revenge. It's all I fucking live for. Fair enough. You play your own game. If you want to reconsider, then come back to me. Just try not to end up on the wrong side of us. Won't be good for your health. My mother wanted me to be a farmer, but I get me hands dirty in other ways.
Do you hear that? When nothing's making a sound, everything's hiding. Maybe we should too.
almost impressed by this mess.
Son? Boy there! Fuck's sake! Okay, it's on. It's Dr. Cuddy. You know, the gum clinic specialist? Yeah, your friendly neighborhood. Have I got a rash or herpes specialist? Right, well, I'm bringing you lot at the MNH headquarters a request for help in these dire times. Now, gather round, because I've got some stories for you. First off, let me tell you about the shortages we've been facing. Supplies have been scarcer than a hen's tooth. We've had to get creative down here. One time, I traded a pack of Radaway for some fancy gloves. Don't ask where I got the Radaway though. That's the stage we're at. Meds for gloves. Now, let's talk about our lovely clinic. We've had folks coming in with the wildest tales. One fella swore he got an infection from a reused needle we had to use. Can you believe it? I told him, son, you've been playing too many tricks. But yeah, it was our fault. But that's a lawsuit avoided, right? Then there was a time when a group of young adults wandered in. They fought. They had some rash from their collective group smashing. I told them, nah, love, you just need a good moisturizer. They laughed, I laughed, we all laughed. But no, they had the clap, but I didn't have the meds for it. Again, that's the stage we're at. And oh boy. Do I remember that one bloke who tried to play off his wounds as a hickey? Bless his heart. But I had to explain that it ain't usual to vacuum about the gaff naked. That ain't cricket here, mate. That one wasn't our fault. That one was just a funny one. Anyways, times are tough, but we're doing our best to keep the folks healthy and laughing. But please, I know you top brass at the MNH have bits we need. Please, just send them down to us. I know times are tough, but please, start sending those care packages to us. We need them too. Stay safe out there from the bombing, though. I hear some bards got hit. Nasty stuff. Be well, and remember, laughter is the best medicine. Cause we ain't got anything else.
What are you doing on this bus?
Rule Britannia!
Where did you come
Britannia
from?
Britannia rule the waves!
Britons never,
can
never,
I help you?
Never shall be slaves.
Greetings, civilian.
Insane to take on the Tommies.
Anything you need? Mind the gap, and all that.
This is a military compound, civilian. State your business. Start talking, then. We have what you're looking for. But they're in high demand, and we don't just hand them out to civilians. Equipment stretched thin as it is, with the hooligans continually kicking us up the arse. If only that were true. The hooligans aren't united under a single banner. They're everywhere, like parasites. Kill one, and two more take their place. But that was you, eh? The John Doe that aided St. Paul's? We heard all about that. Lieutenant Rambeau sends us reports. Follow me. I'll take you to the General.
Corporal Reggie Nux, what can I do for you?
story. I'm afraid I don't follow. Here, this is my position. Got assigned it when I got my promotion. But if you mean the Tommies, I wanted to make my family proud. Especially my dad. He was a soldier like me. Was that what you wanted to hear? Of course. As a matter of fact, yes I do. We've just gotten a report of hooligans congregating near the War Museum. Masses of them. You seem like you can handle yourself. How about it? Putting in the service for your nation? We aren't freelancers. By the time we whip up a squad, the hooligans have already disappeared. Besides, it's too much paperwork. We don't have an exact number, but you can expect enough of a fight. I'd be well armed if I were you. Serving your country isn't enough? I suppose we can throw in 100 or so tickets in there. And of course, you'd be winning the Tommy's gratitude, which goes for a lot. Fantastic! Now, we need you to hit these three locations. The order is up to you. There's a chem den near the museum that needs to be cleared out, as well as an occupied apartment complex and a church courtyard that was taken over. Once you've cleared out these three locations, report back to me for your reward. That is all.
Why would someone go to all this effort for this dump?
Lord Save. To what do I owe this visit, Colonel Major?
General, this is the individual who aided St. Paul's with the hooligans.
Who?
The woman from Lieutenant Rambeau's report.
Oh, I haven't read it yet. If you're here to enlist, you'll have to wait. Basic training programs are backed up for months. You know how it is. Poverty leads to an abundance of would-be soldiers.
They came here looking for a gas mask.
Then why are they walking into my office, Colonel, and not halfway out of the compound?
I thought perhaps they could earn one, sir. You know, mercenary work.
I like your thinking, Colonel. You always win with a mercenary. Either they do the job, or there's no one left to pay. Very well. We have a gas mask with your name on it. Just as long as you... What do we need this so-and-so for, anyway?
After the attack on Guildhall, the remnants of that group moved into the Bank of England. Others have joined them.
Bank of England? There's a Pindar station in there. My great-grandfather grew up in it.
That's very interesting, sir.
All right, you have your orders. Deal with those hooligans in the Bank of England. If we could spare the men, we wouldn't be hiring you. Perhaps Lieutenant Rambeau can help. St. Paul's will be the first to fall if those hooligans rise. Report back to Colonel Major once you're done. Dismissed!
We won't go quietly. You can count on that. Stay safe, civilian. These are dark times.
I wish I could meet the Queen.
Step right up. Take a look. Britannia, Britannia all the waves. Britons never shall be slaves. Ah. You should consider enlisting. We need people like you.
Thank you.
Desperate times call for desperate measures, I suppose.
There you are, you bitch.
Don't think that lot will be bothering us anytime soon. We'll whip them up like double.
What's happened? Eyes. I'm just getting started. Hey.
That was actually kind of fun.
Nature's fluffy smoke rings.
Yeah, and like stars are just the universe's glitter.
What if the trees are like the Earth's way of getting hay, man? They're always reaching for the sky.
Really stoned river. Flowing and twisting through reality, man.
And when you close your eyes, you can hear the whispers of the cosmos, dude. It's like the universe is trying to tell you something.
Speaking of cosmic messages, I could really go for some intergalactic bones beans right now. Like mixed up with pineapple from Neptune or something.
I've done this hundreds of times.
You guys ever wonder if aliens are just out there?
Like,
it's
black holes?
So too.
Are just the universe's way of
looking at us through cosmic telescopes going. Look at those weird earthlings.
Do you think trees get jealous of each other's branches?
Dude, your branches don't even cool. The same stuff.
you close your eyes, you can hear the whispers of the cosmos, dude. It's like the universe is trying to tell you something.
Speaking of cosmic messages, I could really go for some intergalactic bones beans right now. Like mixed up with pineapple from Neptune or something.
You guys ever wonder if aliens are just out there? Getting stoned too. And they're looking at us through cosmic telescopes going, look at those weird earthlings. And maybe, like, black holes are just the universe's way of taking a massive hit. Ha!
Wait, do you think trees get jealous of each other's branches? Like, dude, you're...